What's happening, Hot Wheelers? Joe Motor back with you here for a video of some items that got sent to me by Mr. Davis Sprague, DVS Sprague on YouTube. And Davis, I tried to do a unboxing video and I kept getting interrupted, and then I didn't finish it, and then the file was on my camera, and anyway, it wasn't a continuous video, so I'm just going to show you what Davis sent me. So thank you again for sending me this package. I had sent him a few things and asked him to do a couple of customs, and man, did he deliver. So let me show you what he sent me. First of all, he sent me this wheel swapped sandblaster, and he said he bought this. He actually didn't wheel swap it, but don't matter. Still really cool. Thank you, sir. Sandblaster is sweet, and it's a foreshadow for the piece I'm going to show you at the end, which is just a mind blower. So there's that sandblaster. Also sent me this Deora, which is from like a racing series, 2001 racing series. Sorry for the glare. Really cool Deora with the racing tampos, and got the mobile oil, a really cool Pegasus, the flying horse there. Nice. This is getting cracked. We're going to crack this in a future Crackin' Yak, so stay tuned for that. But that's really, really nice. Got black wall tires, metal base, and the back's got surfboards, and the rubber band that was holding them down came loose, but that's all right. We'll fix that later. And then he sent me these buses, which, Davis, I've been looking for this bus right here for a long time, and I can't believe you sent me three of them. I've almost pulled the trigger many times on these buses, the blue one, and you sent me three of them. This is so cool. I love the racing tampos. I love the gnarly old bus. It's the coolest thing ever. And these fat Goodyear blacked out tires on the bottom. You can see the rust and the metal kind of wearing above the tire there. Really, really love these details. Something that Hot Wheels doesn't do very often. You can see the taped up, the broken window there that's all taped up with cardboard and blue tape, and then a full on cardboard window there. These were really cool pieces. They were licensed by NASCAR, and they were in this little racing series, limited to 25,000. Three in a series of four, I guess. So there's one more. I don't know what the fourth one is. I don't think it says on the back. I'll just show you this really quick. And this is almost reminiscent of Johnny Lightning, because not just because of the detail on the buses, but they give you like detail definitions, which is like a glossary of racing terms, which is really cool. I really love that extra information, because nowadays Hot Wheels just puts legal stuff on the back. There's not really any extra stuff on the back, which I guess people have stopped reading as much, which is a shame, but still, this was cool to have this on the back. But it comes with a little collector card back here in the back, and then the piece. He also sent me the Caterpillar, the yellow bus, which is super cool with the blacked out Goodyear Eagle tires. Really, really cool. Really love these, Davis. This is a home run right here. Blowing my hair back with those. And then the one I've been eyeing for a long time, this one right here. I think Urbanite got one of these, and ever since then I've been after this thing, but I've just never pulled the trigger on buying it. So Davis, thanks very much. This must be my favorite, because it's got the Hot Wheels logo, and this looks really cool. So we'll be cracking those, and I'll show you them up close and personal in a future video. But let me show you what he did. So I'll give you a little hint. I sent him this, which was, you remember this from the racing series, this was a sandblaster, and I think it was all red and black, and I sent him this and I said, how about a zamac with DVS edition, Davis edition zamac sandblaster with neon orange roll cage and grill. And if you've been watching Davis's videos, he's been doing these custom zamacs, so I challenged him and said, how about a zamac sandblaster? And man, did he deliver. So let me show you what he sent. Let me get a little closer here so I can show you the goods. So he didn't just send the sandblaster, he started off with this bone shaker custom zamac. So if you're not subscribed to Davis, I would recommend DVS Sprague. I'll put a link to his channel in the description. He knows a lot about variations. He collects all the blue cards and all the mainline variations, wheel variations, and he knows his stuff. And he's been stripping these and to Zamac and doing wheel swaps. So if you don't know what Zamac is, it basically is an abbreviation for all the metal, the different metals that go into casting a metal Hot Wheels. So it's zinc, aluminum, magnesium, and I think copper are the different mixes of metals. And so that, you know, translates to Zamac. So that's what they call it, Zamac. But look at this thing. This thing is incredible. The wheel choice. Look at the wheels. This red line, blacked out wheels. I think these are from the Indy car. But that is the coolest bone shaker ever, right there. And check out the mean skull front here. Look at that. Man, that is a mean bone shaker right there. And I think this is the only one I need to own. I mean, I may still go after that. There's a Super Treasure Hunt that's a pink bone shaker from last year, I think. I may go after that one, but this is the only other bone shaker I'll ever need to own right there, because that is one mean rat rod. That is fantastic. Wheel choice is great, and it just looks so good stripped down to the Zamac, and Davis's initials are on the bottom there. So there's your bone shaker. And then he sent me another one of my favorites, the Datsun 620 pickup. Look at that thing. Perfect wheel choice on this. It's got orange line tires that are all black on the inside. Couldn't have done better with the tire choice. Really nice. I think those are from Indy cars as well. But I just love how simple, when you take these down to the bare metal, just how simple and cool they look. They look sort of like a project in the garage, but they also look kind of shiny and finished. So I just really enjoy the look of that raw Zamac. And this, the wheels on this couldn't have been better, Davis. Really, really excellent wheel choice. And I'm waiting for them to come out with the premium version of this with a metal base, so customizers can start putting a metal base on this Datsun 620 pickup. But in the meantime, that'll have to do. That is a delicious little custom right there. Look at that. All right, are you ready for the next one? Check this out. Boom. I need Gogo's little bam on a soundbite here. That's amazing. This is the Texas Drive-Em. I sent him a couple of these. These are from the Cocoa Puffs. And, you know, I like Cocoa Puffs, but I just don't want Cocoa Puffs on my Texas Drive-Em, you know? So I sent him one. He stripped it to the bare metal. It had the red bikes in the back and a red top, and it looks like you gnarly up the top. It's like kind of a, looks like a nasty beat-up top there. It's got the red interior and then red-lined tires, which just make it pop. That's a mean-looking Texas Drive-Em. Look at that thing. Really cool. And I don't really collect the Texas Drive-Em. I've said before that you would think I would collect it, because I really do love the lifted off-road trucks. You know, I am in Texas, so you would think this would be a no-brainer for me. But the extended bed doesn't fit in my display case. And there's just something about the stance of the truck that it's problematic to me, and I just like other truck castings better. But I do love this version of it right here. And I do like that RLC version, the blue version. That's probably going to be in my collection eventually, but for now, this is the best Texas Drive-Em that I own. Really cool. All right, and here's the grand finale. Remember that sandblaster I was telling you about? With the, I suggested, how about a custom Zamac sandblaster with a neon orange roll cage and grill? Well, guess what? There it is. Boom! Look at that thing. Fantastic. It looks even better than I imagined. Neon roll cage in the back. It goes all the way into the interior. He must have sprayed all the undercarriage in there with that neon orange grill. And then everything else is stripped bare. That's exactly what I had in mind, yet it looks even better than I thought it would. Look at that thing. This thing is a huge casting, by the way, and for some reason it looks even bigger as a Zamac. I'll set the Texas Drive-Em next to it, and you can see how much bigger it is. It's just a monster truck, man. It's huge. Look at that thing. So these are incredible. Davis, thank you so much for sending me and taking the time to do these customs. They just are unique, one-of-a-kind pieces that you're just not going to see anywhere. And it doesn't get much better than that. So appreciate all the things you sent. I'll be cracking all the other stuff in an upcoming Crackin' Yak video, but I just wanted to share these customs, especially these custom Zamac pieces that Davis Sprague did. Subscribe to his channel if you haven't already. Thanks for watching. We'll see you guys next time.